Hi everyone. So first of all, hello. This is going to be my first makeup tutorial. Okay, so now I'm not a very pro at it, but everybody has been requesting for some sort of a makeup tutorial from me, and so I am compelled to do it. This is going to be a very basic makeup tutorial, like a daily wear makeup tutorial, which you can wear it to office or to a brunch, to a small meeting, like a get together. So let's get started. I'm gonna begin with misting my face. So this is what I'm gonna use. Okay, I have a very oily T-zone, and this helps to control the oil and also keep my face hydrated. So this is what I'm gonna use for now, and I'm gonna just mist my face and will allow it a couple of seconds for all the mist and the hydration to get soaked in, and post which I'm going to moisturize my face. This is basically my daily makeup, daily face routine which I follow. After washing my face, whether it's after taking bath or anytime in the day when I'm washing my face, I follow it up with the mist and a moisturizer. This is what I'm going to use, a Nivea basic moisturizer, because and this has aloe vera also. It has a mint, and it just helps to keep my face very cool, the skin very hydrated. So this is what I'm going to use. I'm just going to take like a little bit of moisturizer and just gonna rub it in my fingers to warm it a bit and spread it all over my face. So I'm going to just start with rubbing it upwards to avoid any wrinkles or sagging of the skin, and just spreading it basically under my eyes. And yeah, we'll give it 5 minutes for all the moisturizing and all the mist to soak in, and post which we'll follow it up with the makeup. See you in 5 minutes. Okay, so we are post 5 minutes, and now we're just gonna prime our face. Because we are looking to have a very glowy face, I'm using this Sivana primer. It has a little bit of glitter particles, not over the top glitter particles, but somewhere in between, which just gives you a very natural glow from within, and it smells great. Okay, so I'm just gonna take like a little bit of this, like say this much, and again we are going to rub it between our palms, just rubbing between our fingers, and this spreading it all over. It's silicone based, so it will help you hide your pores. Now as you can see, I'm just simply using my fingers on my neck and on my forehead, my nose area, because that's major oil factory at my nose. And so the thumb rule is, after using your primer, do not immediately start adding your foundation and your BB cream or whatever, because it tends to slip away, and it would not hold the foundation or the layer of any other product that you apply, because it is as is, it's still setting in. Okay, so we'll allow it another 2 minutes to set in and follow it up with foundation. Okay, so we are post 2 minutes. Now as you can see, I have a little bit of hyperpigmentation on my eyes and my lips area, and I have a little bit of spots here and there. So before we apply a foundation, I need to cover this up so it doesn't show from the foundation. Normally for under eyes, it is advisable to use orange or peach tone to cover the under eyes or the purple hyperpigmentation, but I couldn't find something that suits my under eye, like the perfect color that would conceal it. So what I'm going to use this orange color. This is from Purple Cosmetics. I'm going to use this orange color just a little bit on the back of my palm, and I'm going to mix it with a retinol concealer. It gives me the perfect peach tone, like this. It gives me the perfect peach tone that would cover my under eyes. Okay, so I'm just gonna mix it with my fingers. So this is kind of color that I would like, And I'm just going to spread it under my eyes. And as you can see, it has already started to show difference between both the eyes. Yeah, see. Right? This is, I'm just going to dab with my fingers. Fingers are the best form of blending anything, because A, it does not absorb the product, B, it just helps you spread it evenly. Okay, so same process we're going to do with the other eye. Take a little bit of orange, and a little bit of concealer. Okay, and I'm just going to mix it again and do my other eye. So this gives you the flawless, not exactly flawless, but at least it would cover your dark circles to an extent. And it also gives you a base for any eyeshadow that you would like to do. Same goes for my hyperpigmentation, so I would repeat and come back. Okay, so I've covered all the hyperpigmentation on my face, on the sides, around my lips, and now we are going to do a foundation. This is my favorite foundation from Yves Rocher, and I'm just going to take again at the back of my hand. And just gonna put the dots all over my face and my neck. How it would look like. I'm not a very brush or a sponge person. I love to spread it evenly with my fingers, but for the video purpose I'm just gonna use the Dab Beauty sponge and spread it evenly. Okay, so this is how it would look like somewhat. Now the beauty sponges tend to absorb a lot of product, so if you're a person who likes like a full coverage, you can go with another layer. But if you're someone like me who likes a sheer coverage, who likes to have a more natural looking face and not a layered face, then you can just leave it at there. Also, because we are going for a very dewy and sun-kissed and a glowy look, we would not set it with a compact or a loose powder, because otherwise, if you can see this glow here, yeah, that would go away. Okay, so we would leave it at there and we'll follow it up with the other layer. Okay, so now we are through with our primer, we are through with our concealing, we are through with our base makeup. And now is the time to enhance the eyes. For enhancing the eyes, because you're going for a very, very natural look, you can either just kajal or eyeline it, or you can also add a little bit of color to your eyes. So I'm gonna just add a little bit of color to my eyes today to show you how it would look. What I'm gonna use is, I'm gonna use this palette from Revolution. It's called Neutrals 2 palette. It has all the pink neutral shades. Some transition shades, a highlighter. I'm gonna start off with say pink, this one. Okay, so just gonna, it's not exactly a pink, but it's, because the camera quality is showing where it's pink, it's more like an orangey peachy shade. I don't know if the camera picks up. Yeah, that one. Okay, so we're just gonna add it on our eyes and just blend it. It's super pigmented, so if you can see how pigmented it is. And then we're gonna do it other eye, just that back, and then spread. sorry, blend. Because I'm not very good at the blending thing clearly, because it's kind of uneven. Nonetheless, I'm learning. Okay, this is how it look like. To add more depth to whatever we've done, I'm just gonna go with a transition shade, like a brown over here, or we can do a darker brown if you prefer. I would prefer a very day look, so I'm going with a lighter color and just adding a depth at the corners. About it, that's the whole I thing that we're gonna do, and just leave it at there because we want a very natural looking and not over the top eyes. Yeah, so we leave it at there. Now our next step is the eyeliner. The eyeliner I'm going to use is the Lakme Absolute 925 eyeliner. You can also use the gel liner, but I prefer a liquid liner for my day-to-day use, because gel is something that it takes consume a lot of time, and I'm sure nobody has that kind of a time on day-to-day basis. So I'm just gonna quickly do my eyeliner and get back. Okay, so we're done with the liner, and as you can see, I've done a very very basic liner. Now what we can do is we need to do a mascara. For that, I'm gonna curl my lashes. Now I'm not someone who's blessed with like amazing lashes, so I need to keep on doing something to my lashes. What we can do is I have this curler which we'll use and to curl our eyes. Okay, so I'm just gonna use my hand mirror because I'm not very good at it. This is how we're going to do. Okay, curling my eyelashes for a couple of seconds. As you can see, and same I'm going to repeat with my other eye. Curl our lashes, and now I'm going to do loads of mascara. The mascara I'm going to use is the Voluminous L'Oreal Lash Paradise. It's an amazing mascara. It would instantly just open up your eyes, and it would give your eyes more dimension. Okay, so I'm just going to use again my hand mirror. Now, I'm a person who loves using mascara. If you do not like using mascara on a day-to-day basis, you can skip this step. This is how it would look on a closer. You can see the difference. Okay. And same you're going to repeat with the other eye. Add loads and loads of mascara. That's the mascara I've been using. Looks kind of clumsy here. Yeah. So that's it. Now what we're gonna do is this step can completely skip, but I love it. Now because we've done a little eyeshadow, what we would normally do is we would just do a little bit of eyeshadow running right under the eye. For that I'm gonna use something like this. Something like this. Something which is like a flat shader brush. Okay, I don't know if it's catching properly. No, it's not. Okay, what earlier we used was a little fluffier brush for the blending process. I'm going to use this regular flat shader brush and just gonna shade the same shadow that we used under my eye. So we use a little peachy tone, that I'm gonna use first, and just go right below my eye. The other eye. And then take the brown shade, do the brown one, and just do the corners. Okay, we have a good look. I know it's a little scary right now, but trust me, the end result will be amazing. I'm gonna take the mascara again. My lower eyelashes. This is what I absolutely love doing, my lower lashes. It just opens up your eye. It just looks amazing, especially in the photographs, like the closer photographs. It looks amazing. Yeah, so we're done here with the eyes. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna bring dimension to our face, because what has happened is with the foundation our face looks flat. You can use a bronzer, but I do not suggest you to use a bronzer on day-to-day basis, because it would be just layering up your face with products unnecessarily. But if you want to use, you can go ahead. If you know how to use it, please go ahead. I'm just gonna simply put a dimension by adding a little color to my face, like in the form of a blush. This is what I'm going to use. This is the best blush out there. It's called NARS, and the shade is Orgasm. This is the best-selling blush to date. It's not available in India. I'm not sure if the airports are doing it, but there are no outlets in India. So I'm just going to... This is how the shade is. It has the... If you can see, it is pink with little gold tinge, and I'm just gonna take a little bit of the product with the blush brush and just no smiling. Yeah, that's the rule, because I have a very round face. I'm gonna take the blush right from here up to my cheeks. It's bringing a dimension to the face. And blend it outwards. Okay. Yeah, so that's how it's gonna look. I'm just blending it outwards. Okay, and now comes my favorite part, the highlight. The moment you add highlight to your face, I don't know how amazing it would look on the camera, especially on my camera, but it would light up your face like anybody's business. So I'm gonna take the Master Chrome Highlight from Maybelline with this brush. You can use a fan brush. I'll show you how it looks like. This is how it looks like. I'm not a big fan of it, so I'm gonna use this. It gives you highlight on point. Okay, so I'm just gonna do something like this and like this, a C over here. Same I do here. I take it right up like this and do a C over here. Now you can either bluff it or you can spray it with your fingertips and just blend it right into your blush. Oh my god, see the glow. You see that? The points where you need to highlight is obviously your cheekbones, all the high points, that is, the cheekbones, your nose tip, and your cupid's bow. See that. Now along with that, we are going to do the inner corners as well and the brow bone. So I'm going to take the same flash of the brush and do my inner brows, inner corners of my eyes. Just highlight it. Now this highlighter is not a very chalky highlighter. It blends like a dream. It is too buttery. It's soft and it gives you that glow which you like from within. So if you see on a closer look, you would not even come to know if it's a highlighter or it's the inner glow. Okay, look at that. Okay. I know my eyes look a little weird. My face is a little flat. What we missed over here is we missed doing the brows. On purpose, they did not do the brows because I'm not a brow person. So I didn't do it because I'm naturally blessed with amazing brows. However, you can always do your brows. If you want, I can do a separate tutorial on how to do your brows and how to fill in your brows. For now, let's finish up this look with the lipstick. Because it's a very natural look, we would go for something like a nude shade. My favorite nude shades include pinks and browns, like baby, not the baby pink ones, but the natural pink ones. What I'm going to use is this lipstick from Smashbox. Okay, this is the shade I'm going to use, and this shade I believe is called Driver's Seat, if I'm not wrong. And the way we're going, it's a liquid lipstick, it's a matte liquid lipstick. The way we're going to apply it is just go right at your cupid's bow and do a V. Okay. And outline your lips. Start feeling it. Very natural glowy makeup which you can do on day-to-day basis. I know it sounds like a very long process. Trust me, it's not. It's just that I took a little time. I'm a newcomer. I'm a completely amateur doing it for the first time. I hope you like it. And that's the complete look. I hope you like my video. Do like. Thank you.